constant. I'd go to rugby with my dad every Sunday. And every Saturday night I'd be sent out for the Green Sports Mail. Probably doesn't mean a lot to you if you're not from Hull. Well, I'll give you a thumbs up, he obviously got sent there as well by your dad.
I remember waiting for
him. Yeah, 5-6 o'clock on a night. Nowadays, I take my dad to rugby because he's in a wheelchair, but we don't have the Green Sports Mail anymore. And I was fortunate enough to interview Paul Cook last week. And one of the things he said to me was how much he misses the Green Sports Mail. Partly because every little lad was a hero for a week in there. No matter how young you were, what position you played, or what division you were in, you got mentioned in that magazine. Everybody loved it. I loved it. I got a couple of mentions in there. I was playing football. Believe it or not, I was a goalkeeper. Don't laugh. Nothing got past me. Still doesn't. So, the ethos behind tonight and behind the guys who stood in that corner there is that we want to bring some of that back. We want to get the younger lads back involved. We want to get the smaller teams involved. We want to get the minority sports. I've just been speaking to Chris at the back and Becky. They're drag racers. And they don't get a mention anywhere. Yeah, Chris, did you say he was a British champion?
Yeah.
Right. Nobody would know him. If he stood on your toes in the street, you wouldn't know who he was. I didn't know who he was. Well, these are the people we need to get back into the spotlight. We need to get your kids as well in the spotlight. If you've got little ones who play football on a Sunday. Ian, you're one of the coaches at Cot Tigers. You've got loads of little kids there. None of them get championed. You know, we've got the next generation of Paul Cooks. We've got Richard Holmes. You've got Nicky Bambis out there. Nobody's talking about them. That's why we want to put it all together in this magazine. Now, my expertise is rugby league, believe it or not. I don't know a lot about football, but I've got some lads over there who do. Two of them are mad keen North Ferriby fans. And I think we've got a guy in here tonight from Ferriby, is that right? Yep. And they don't get they don't also get the press they deserve. But yeah, last year was a fantastic year for them. Huge promotion. But yeah, it's been lost in the mire that is Hull City, because they've got all the lion's share of the publicity, good and bad. Now, we don't want to be focusing on the bad as well. We would like to see good things happen with this. So I'm going to bring Jack up now, and Sam. Sam Shepherd, Jack Salt. Now, these are the guys who write and they interview the guys at Ferriby as well. They've done a really good job. If you've been following us on Twitter and Facebook, they've been doing some fantastic interviews with the lads at Ferriby. You even had the manager on the coach with you, I believe, the other day, was it?
Yeah. I had interviews with Steve Roushan, yeah, and the assistant.
Yeah. See, this is the sort of thing that we need to promote a lot of, because it's not getting promoted. We know the mainstream media in Hull is pretty much the whole Daily Mail, and they're writing what they want, and a lot of it is alarm-focused. We know that Hull Kingston Rovers went down last year. Apparently so, yeah. So that a lot of it was focused on there as well, but we've also got some good stories in Hull. We've got a lot to tell. Not just Chris at the back there, not just your kids from Ferriby, who nobody knows about. Now, you two, obviously, you know these guys pretty well. And what sort of publicity do they get normally?
They get basically nothing. And whatever it is, it's just quickly put together, and they don't go in depth with anything. It's just the result and nothing else really, even though they're at the highest level they've ever been, and they should never realistically have got to that level, but through sheer tenacity last season they did it. But yeah, it's just not highlighted enough in my opinion.
No, we agree. We know as well that there's also below that level as well, there's other teams that are there that are also feeding the bigger teams. We know that we have two pretty well-known rugby league teams. And there's teams below them, your West Hulls, your Scarlers, Isbergs. They're also providing the new heroes who you'll be reading about 3, 4, 5 years down the line, who are going to be lifting Challenge Cups, FA Cups, etc. We want to be talking to these people as well, and we are doing quite a lot. We've got some really good interviews coming up. We've got one with Paul Cook that I've done myself, and we've got one that I think Dave did with Josh Hodgson.
Yeah.
Another success story from the city. Now he's having it large in the NRL, which is the best league in the world for rugby league. And we're going to be talking to these people. Josh Mantelato, who I think Ian's down there, he's another one of our guys. He did a fantastic interview with an outgoing player from Hull Kingston Rovers. But we also want the smaller guys in there. And we want you all to talk to us as well. Tell us what you want. You're all part of some sort of sporting excellence and achievement in this city. Pretty much all of you. We want to talk to you. We want to get you out there. We want to get you promoted. So the next one I want to pull up is Dave. This is Dave Wilkinson. Got that. Dave's one of our regular contributors as well. He provides a lot of content with us for Hull FC, etc. Big Hull FC fan. What are you going to be bringing to us?
At the minute, do some writing for the Hull FC fanzine, the Upper Cream. And my role, certainly within the FanaticHull magazine, will be based on rugby league, based on Hull FC. The previews that are in the magazine tonight are ones that I've written. And I think being a lifelong black and white fan, there's nothing better than beating up on Hull Kingston Rovers. But I think the magazine itself is going to give us more of an unbiased approach. We all read the media that's churned out by the professional clubs in the city, and very rarely do you actually learn anything new. You see player interviews and you don't really hear that much different from one player to the next because they're schooled in what they're saying. And it's the same from the clubs themselves. It's not really aimed to enlighten the fans or inform the fans on what's actually going on. And I think certainly one of the things that we're looking to do is write and talk about the clubs that we love from a fan's point of view. And, you know, discuss whether things are going well or things are going badly. And I think the way that we see the magazine itself is really two sides. One is to look at the mainstream professional clubs in the city and try and give that fan's eye view, that fan's approach to how the reporting of their achievements or their disappointments. And then the other side of it is on the lesser known, the non-professional side of it, certainly with the amateur rugby league, rugby union, the football, and as I said, even the ladies' football is going to be covered. I don't know if many of you will be following the Facebook and Twitter FanaticHull, but that's one area that we're wanting to concentrate on. The social media aspect is how lots of people, certainly these days, get their information. We want to supplement that with a magazine. There's lots of content that's going to be unique in the magazine that's not going to be put up onto the website or put into social media. So again, we're trying to go back to, as Sean said, the sort of sports mail approach with the magazine, but also have a few extra features in there and extra things on the social media as well. So across the group of writers and contributors, I think we've got something like 20,000 followers on Twitter. I know Sean's got about 3, but but that's just one aspect that we're looking to contribute with, and we see it as a three-pronged attack. One is the magazine, one is the website, and one is the social media side of things. So hopefully that's going to be a success.
Cheers, Dave.
We're not looking to make money out of this, if anybody's wondering. We just want to do something. We all got together about a year ago, wasn't it? We do a radio show on Monday nights, occasionally Wednesdays and Thursdays, on Hull Kingston Radio. I'll give you a plug now. And we're getting a lot of tweets from people who are trying to get their side across, and they don't get it across in the mainstream media. I know I spoke to Andy, an old friend of mine over there. He's constantly frustrated at what goes on and what isn't said at some of these clubs and what he wants to see when he reads a magazine or when he reads a website. We will give you a fan's eye view. You will see what we see from it. We're not going to spin. There's going to be no doctoring of the text. We're not going to get involved with the clubs themselves because they'll just tell us what they want you to hear. We don't want that. If there's something happening on the pitch that's not good, we'll tell you about it. And we know the Hull Daily Mail was pretty much spinning Hull KR's terrible season last year. They didn't focus on the fact that they only won a handful of games. And that's what people need to read. They don't want to be they don't want the wool pulled over their eyes anymore. You are paying 60p a night for this paper. We can do it weekly for a couple of quid, and you'll get the news from everything. If your kids are in the sport, you'll get a mention, they'll get a mention. Go on, grab us, send us an email. We're happy to come and talk to your teams. I've also got Darren in the sidelines there, waiting patiently. This is Darren Shepherd, Sam's dad. He's another Hull FC fan. He likes his football as well, so he'll give you a bit of insight on his contribution.
Nice hockey nowadays.
Nice hockey.
Yeah, basically, Sean said, mad Hull FC fan. That's always been my sport. A bit like Sean, going from that big, and we had all the way through, everywhere and anywhere. Taking Sam on, bro, sport mad. But since this idea came up, FanaticHull, I realised how many different sports and clubs that are even recognised in this city and how interesting the sports are, particularly from my side. I have a goddaughter who plays for Hull City Ladies, and I mentioned it to her mum, and she said it's a fantastic idea. And I got out there, now I tweet about the games, I put stuff out about the games, and they retweet everything for us. And they're just glad of the exposure because they don't get it anywhere in the Old Daily Mail. Don't get it on the website or nothing. Hull Pirates is the same. When we first put out, we did a countdown in December, an advent calendar countdown. And Sam and Jack did magnificent different research, pictures of everything. 2 days in, because we put two mainstream sports, we had a tweet from Hull Pirates fans saying, typical, you say you're a new sport, looking at new sport, but you are covering us. And we said, well, give us a chance, a few days. And then, lo and behold, pre-planned picture of Hull Pirates. They followed us. We tweeted commentaries on the games. We put Bellin stuff out for the games. And it's so appreciated by the fans. Fans of other clubs have followed us. People who you never expect to follow a sport magazine or website dedicated to Hull. Following, because we give them the time and mention there that they're playing one of our teams, and it's spreading the word of the sports, and it's the smaller sports that we really appreciate. And as Sean said, we're not here to toe the party line, City Rovers and Hull FC. They've got their own media propaganda machines to do that. We're here as independent people with our own thoughts and our own opinions. There's more people more expert than me, North Ferriby for example, these two lads. They know everything, probably more than most people at Ferriby have ever known. Sean and Dave, they're obviously, you can tell they're older than me, so they know about what's more about them. Especially Sean.
Are they heavier than you? I don't know.
So, I'll tend to do, write an opinion piece. The lads will say, look at, say for example yesterday, the city manager changing. Instead of just the spin of who he is or what he's done, we could take it from a different angle. You'll see pieces from me about that. It might be the main topic, but digging a bit deeper that Hull City might not want you to know, or Rovers might not want you to know, or Hull City might want something special and specific promoting. I'll take the time to put that out there on the website, maybe in the magazine. But we're all united as one, that there's enough people in this city who don't get a fair voice from the mainstream media, and we'll be there and prepared to do it. And as Sean said, you want us to come down to a training session, talk to one of your people. You've got a player who's achieved something that no one had ever heard of because it's not where they're going in the Old Daily Mail. We'll put it out there and we're championing the course. And it's people like that that need people like us. If sport's important to you, then it's important to us. And that's my mantra with this. We're willing to learn everything and anything about other sports. We'll make mistakes along the way. Unintentional mistakes, but we will learn and we'll take the time to learn it, because it's not just three big clubs in all. There's thousands of clubs, there's thousands of kids, there's thousands of people, all different colours, creeds, walks, ethnicities, who don't get.
It's a big way for you, that.
I know. I've been practicing that all the time. Wikipedia. I don't know what it means. But. So, yeah, if we are there, email anything. Get in touch and we'll do our best to promote it for you.
And can I just say off the back of that, we know the scope's there for this, because the amount of support we've had already from people in this room, from social media, from everything, has been unbelievable. The amount of different clubs, people from clubs messaging us saying, can you come down to our training session, can we email you, can we send you media passes so you can get into our games and cover us? It's been, well, I've been gobsmacked by it, and I just think this is going to be a massive success.
Just adding to that as well, at the end of the day, we're not journalists, we're fans. We're fans of these clubs. Me and Sam, we've been going to Ferriby for 6 or 7 years now. We've been going as fans. We've not been going as people who want to write massive pieces about the game, where all the pieces that are about Ferriby and that are coming from mine and his perspective, not from what everybody wants to hear from the journalists. That's from, if we think Ferriby are playing bad, we'll say it. We'll put it in the magazine. It won't be any propaganda that you see from any of the clubs. Even with Hull City, I was a massive Hull City fan for all my upbringing. And then I fell out of love with it because obviously of the new owners and all the situations that have been going on. And if I feel that I'm not welcome there, I'll say it. I'll write down what I think about what is happening in that club. And I will write down what I believe is better about going to watch Ferriby than going to watch Hull City. And at the end of the day, all the pieces that are in that magazine that you'll see at the end of tonight are opinion pieces. They're not pieces that journalists have written. They're from our perspectives. They're all opinions that we want everybody else to understand. That's what I want to say about it.
Well, brilliant, Jack. About 7 or 8 cliches you put in there. At the end of the day, our neck of the woods. We've got a man in the room who's pretty much a hater of cliche, but we won't point him out. I'm just conscious actually that you seem to think that we're all Hull FC fans. We do have a Hull KR fan on our books.
But he's gone missing.
We don't talk about him. He doesn't want to come up and talk because he's a little bit shy. But. Fair comment. But Ian is also contributing to us. You may follow him on Twitter as Sydney Kidney, so you feel free to beat him up at the door on the way out. He'll be providing a lot of the humorous pieces in there. He's also an Everton fan, would you believe? Yes, it's all going quiet. Did you see that? Yeah, exactly. Ian's there in the middle, his lovely wife Julie, so he'll also be contributing. We also have a bit of a local celebrity in the room. We have a Hull crime writer who was also contributed for us, and I'm really, really pleased for this because his work is absolutely excellent. If you do find any of his books in Waterstones, then please buy one because you'll love it. I'll steal one, if you're from Liverpool. So I'm just going to bring up Nick Quantrill. You might have seen him actually if you bring him down to the Made in Hull installation. His head is 30 foot large and he's projected on the Ferriby building.
It's very scary.
It's very scary, yeah, you will have nightmares.
It's generally quite scary.
Yeah.
I was into culture before it was trendy.
I was so recently
in the culture. I'm very interested in being a sports writer, which kind of makes me a bit weird. I maybe stood up here, isn't it? So, I've been doing a radio show with these guys for like the last year or so, and when they started the magazine, I just kind of got this idea that I wanted to write a bit about where sport and culture sort of collides, because I think in a city like Hull, where we have 3 professional teams as well as all the grassroots stuff going on, sport is such an important part of the city, and essentially sport is culture, isn't it? And culture is sport in this city, so I just wanted to kind of tap into that, because I don't think that's something the City of Culture team are going to do particularly this year. I mean, I think we're going to see a lot of really, really good stuff come out of City of Culture in terms of regeneration and so on, but I don't think we're going to see an awful lot to do with the sports teams in this city. I think the rugby league teams do it pretty well, to be fair, in terms of working with arts and communities. Not so much Hull City, as we know. So I just wanted to try and just kind of do a little bit about that. So things, when we have things like books coming out relating to the football teams, rugby teams in Hull, we've had players in here about sport, anything where we have that kind of sort of collision between them two worlds is something I wanted to sort of do a little bit of writing about. So in the first edition, there's a book review of Ian Bunton's 46 and Counting, and Ian's over there, and it's a kind of a book, and I think people need to read it because it's not just about Hull City getting promotion last season, it's kind of an everyman tale of what this club has become, really, you know, and the disillusionment that's setting amongst the fan base. I think these kind of things need sort of talking about and just giving a little bit of publicity where they won't necessarily get them in a mainstream press. So that's kind of what I want to do, is just sort of try and connect sport and culture a little bit more than maybe what is elsewhere. Like I say with these lads, just get in touch and we'll see what we can do.
There is another member of our guys, the final one, it's Ben. Now he's a young lad and his writing is pretty, pretty good. He's another Hull KR fan, so we laugh at him a lot. Ben Towse, he currently works voluntarily for the City of Hull Academy, which is the joint academy of rugby league players that are coming through the ranks at Hull FC and Hull KR, so they'll be heading into Super League and heading into the Championship any day now. Unfortunately, he can't be with us today because he's working. Terrible excuse. I just wanted to give him a bit of a mention. That's it, really. You've met us all. You've heard our little bit of a tale. I've been following rugby now, this is my 40th year I've been going. Between us, we have a lot of expertise. We have a lot to say, and we have a lot of criticism as well, which you'll read a lot about, I would hope. So feel free to grab us when you put your drinks down, and if there's anything you want to tell us that wants to go in it, then that's great.
What's that?
Sorry, I can't see you.
All right then.
Yes, sir.
All right. My name's Chaz. You mentioned something to do with the internet, but you haven't actually mentioned any Twitter or any Facebook and things.
Okay.
Social media stuff.
Yeah. In the magazine around there, you'll see our Twitter name, which is at FanaticHull.
Fair enough.
It was on the screen, but the projector's gone pop. Never mind. Facebook is also FanaticHull. We have www.fanatichull.com. We are updating that as we speak, more or less. That's one of my roles within it. So we'll get the news on as much as we can. If anything breaks, we'll try and get it on really, really quickly. Opinions on games, you'll get that as well, so feel free to jump on there. There will also be a definitive list of where you can buy our magazine. We are aiming to get it out to pretty much every game that we can. There'll be one of our sellers there with a badge on, so it's on sale tomorrow, yeah, Hull City, and on Sunday at the Hull FC Hull KR Derby as well. Ferraby as well, I believe. So if you don't pick up a copy tonight, then pass the word around and somewhere, sometime you'll get one. We will be doing a subscription for this as well, and a digital version, but that's a little bit in the future because we're getting a bit ahead of ourselves. We wanted to get it out for 2017, as Nick's already mentioned, with the culture year, and we want to get involved in that in a big way. The sport, to us, is our culture. We're not writers. Nick's the writer, so he's up to his neck in culture, really. We're just plebs, basically. So if you've got a story to tell, we want to hear it. We'll tell it for you. We'll get your support. We'll get your people out into the spotlight where they should be.
Can I just say, that's a good question about social media, because that's a big thing for us. So if you're on Twitter, if you're on Facebook, Twitter at FanaticHull, and any likes, shares, retweets, follows, much appreciated, just to get the word out there quicker for us so we can cover as much as possible and get it out to as many people as possible.
We've all worked hard with social media. We all have a certain input into it, and we think it's just giving something back to everyone else who obviously follows Twitter and everything. We think it's a great way of communicating, not just through the magazine and through the website, but at the end of the day, everybody uses social media, don't they?
Yeah.
You don't get behind in the times.
Another aspect to that as well is when we've got some of the mainstream clubs playing away from home. We will be doing some video as well at the games, updates, and just keeping fans up to date who can't necessarily travel to the other side of the country on a Friday afternoon, Saturday afternoon or Sunday or Friday, Friday evening. So that's there as well.
Any other questions for anyone? Yes.
I think that
perspective. It's definitely fans. We're not in it because we want to make a job out of this. We've all got jobs. Sam and Jack are students, obviously hard at work every weekend. and every week. I said that with a really straight face.
Yeah,
yeah.
Staying in bed is hard work.
Yeah. Still tasting toothpaste at 2:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's definitely from a fan's perspective. We're not journalists. Nobody knows us. You didn't know us until you came in this room. I mean, I've got 4,000 followers on Twitter, but you wouldn't know me, basically. So, yeah, probably for the best. Yeah, because you don't want to beat me up. But no, we're not aiming to be superstars with this. We don't want to be. We're quite happy just to have no name on our articles as well. We just really want to do this sort of thing. And
we just all share a passion for sport, don't we? And we want to get that across.
Yeah, there was no talking about this. We all got involved.
At the end of the day, the name's FanaticHull. We're all fanatic about sport, you know. So we're, at the end of the day, we're fans, and we want other people to feel our perspectives and where we're coming from. I mean, that's all we want from it, really. Is.
Sean, I've passed your name forward to the Undisputed League Secretary who'll get in touch with you for. I know that you put in the back of it for this fixtures for football, so if you'll get in touch with you for the amateur game for fixtures.
We're happy to do that, we're absolutely happy.
That's great from the amateur perspective, and I know that's where we're really coming from, and from the fans' point of view. How are you going to deal if the actual professional clubs, the main three that I've mentioned, not it's the ice hockey yet, but the Hull, the Rovers and the City, if anybody from the club contacts you and they want pieces put in? How are you going to deal with it from the point of view of that
build?
Put their skin on it?
Absolutely not. It will be just, as long as we can do the interview and we can see it from our side, that's absolutely fine. We'll do it as a fan. As if you bumped into a player in the street, we want to know. But we know that the whole FC, at the minute, they're embargoed against talking to anybody else, apart from approved media outlets. We're not approved. I'm not bothered about being approved. We don't care. We want our side of it. If you're going to call somebody in the street and say,
so
you was terrible.
The radio program.
Yeah, exactly. You know, there's no holds barred on the radio. Yeah, exactly. And you know, because you've been on it. And yeah. Obviously, you're banned now for a few weeks. But, but no, as Dave's going to say now.
I think one of the key aspects is, if you're looking at current players who are playing for professional clubs, they have the media training. They know what they're allowed to say, and you could line half a dozen of them, have an interview with each of them, and you hear the same thing.
Club.
Yeah. Yeah. You're not going to learn anything new. That's why the interviews that we've done with players are either players that have left the club, or have retired, or aren't involved in the city. So you get more information out of them, you get more of a perspective.
And the hands aren't tied.
Yeah, the hands aren't tied, and they are, you know, trying to second guess the next question you're going to ask, and has that been drummed into them at media day? So the answer was a simple answer to your question is no. We won't be carrying direct information straight from the clubs.
By the same score, we're not here to use ex players to score points against off left seat. If it's an ex left seat player or whatever, we want to hear what their genuine thoughts were with a time at the club or anything. We're not there to put spin on. We're not there to put Rovers down, FC down, City down. If a player wants to tell us anything, we'll just say it open and honestly. We're the mouthpiece for people, for the smaller clubs. We, as Sean said, we're not here to get fame or infamy. We're here to spread the word, as it were, of other clubs. The three main clubs have their own propaganda machine anyway. They don't need us. We're a small band of people who are just mad keen about sport. I mean, Sam and his mum had to listen. She had to listen endlessly, and his brother, who was no interest in sport whatsoever, endlessly to me and him talking, debating, arguing, whatever you want to call it about sport. And I was the same with my dad. And it's healthy debate. We can have healthy debate amongst us all in here and have disagreements. And believe me, me and Ian, AKC, I'll have more than enough agreements about Hull and Rovers. Because that's what fans are. We're doing this from a fan's perspective. Because he's fanatical about Rovers, which he can't be helped. His medication doesn't work. And I'm fanatical about all of whatever Sid says will always be wrong to me, and whatever I say will always be wrong to him. But that's my point of view. That's Sid's point of view. It's not Hull FC's media man telling me what to say or what he wants others to hear. It's what we think and what we think we want to say. And if they don't like it, quite frankly, they could lump it. We won't be libelous or slanderous or anything, but it's from us lads here, it's our point of view. And believe me, my wife was certainly going to listen to me say how rubbish UFC have been in the past and how good they've been in the past. But that'll be my, what I say in that magazine is what I believe at the time. He might think they're brilliant and I might think they're crap, but that's his opinion, that's my opinion. There'll be no censorship on our part, but we're not out there to crucify anybody, and we're not out there. And if player, ex-players and players want to talk to us, we're more than willing to put their point of view across, because that's what they want the fans to hear. So that's where we're coming from.
Finished?
I know.
Does that answer your question, Ian?
It does. I'll just add one thing to it, though.
Okay.
Will you be willing to take feedback from fans responding to your articles?
Oh, good God. Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
That's,
yeah.
That's what I want.
Yeah. Yeah.
React to it, but would you put their opinions?
You'll be in the magazine alongside us, if that's what you want.
What
obviously, we're going to have to get through the censors and the lawyers, but yeah.
And they're willing to write something to us. How do they, have you I know, we know, because we're here. How will they get to know? Just by reading the magazine themselves, and there'll be details in there to contact you?
You'll just get through social media. You can contact us on the email. If you've got something to say to us, if you think we're wrong, fine, absolutely, I don't care.
Don't just direct to me, I'm not going
to be really mad. No, I am directing, we know what you're like.
At the end of the day, mate, we all have disagreements ourselves. We don't all agree on the same thing. I'll think something, Daz or Dave or Sean will think you, mate. We all disagree, but that's a fan's point of view between
exactly,
ourselves.
Yeah.
We're happy to hear what other people... If anybody thinks what I've written is rubbish, fine, tell me why.
So let's ban from the
absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. We,
absolutely.
We know we're doing what we want to achieve if people are responding to us.
Brilliant.
That's the only way you can improve.
That's the thing. We want the debate. Yeah, that's the thing.
Anyone else?
Yeah, just come on the sponsorship, looking through the initial.
Sorry, what's your name is?
Simon.
Simon.
Hi. You've got several sponsors already,
mm-hmm.
Correct?
Yeah.
Just with a view to obviously what you said earlier, it's not a commercial enterprise, it's a passion, it's fanatic. What about the sustainability going forward? Obviously you want to keep this going for a long time. Is there inroads into other funding or sponsorship?
At the minute we're funding a lot of this from our own pockets, but we have found sponsors, advertisers, mostly the ones that are sponsoring the teams that you're all supporting yourselves. I know we've got Bamboo and they're massive for UFC and they put a lot of money into there as well. We also want to feed off that. We also want to get them involved. So when they see a whole FC article and they see Bamboo under it, there's going to be a bit of a connection there as well. So yeah, we can't pay this out of our own pocket infinitely. We just want to cover it. And we want to be, the ethos behind this towards the end, which we've all discussed, we want to sponsor a young kid's team as well. We want to make enough to buy them the shirts that they're always appealing for, to buy them the equipment. And if they run out with our name on the front of their shirts, that's mission accomplished for all of us, I think. We know that Ian from Cot there, they're always after new kit, new balls, everything like that.
Every club is.
Everyone is, because they're all fighting for this little bit of coin that's out there. And we want to help that. We'll also be doing charity events and things, you know, with sport in mind. I was hoping we'd get Kai from the Electric Eels wheelchair rugby team in here, but obviously you can't make it tonight, probably the traffic, etc. But that's another one that's quite close to us. We all know Kai. He comes on the radio with us as well. And they've got a massive tale to tell, and they're not getting the exposure that they deserve. They do a hell of a lot of work in the community, this Electric Eels team. I urge you to go out and look them up. Go and see what they do. Absolutely fantastic. They're all in the electric wheelchairs. They've all got various disabilities. But it's not stopped them. You know, and that's what we want to put forward to everybody as well. Everybody's in here is pretty much able-bodied. These guys aren't. Nobody's talking about them. So, was that your only question, Simon?
There was just one thing. I think it's admirable that you're actually releasing a print issue, because obviously the decline of print, you know, I mean, bucking that trend with an independent publication is quite, from my perspective anyway, quite refreshing, because social media has a place, but
it does, but if you look at our slogan, our motto, if you like, it's at your fingertips. So every fan are going to go into the games with this in their back pocket folded. We don't want to be a big, huge newspaper.
No.
Eventually, we may go bigger, but I doubt it. We're quite happy with the format that we've got. Everybody's going to pick it up, they're going to scribble in it. they're going to look at the back page and they're going to say, right, I'm going to email these, they've got it wrong. They're not talking to me. I'll talk to them.
Put your lottery numbers on it or whatever, you know, it's there and it's tangible.
Yeah, you'll have the fixtures for the coming week. You'll have we're possibly looking at City of Culture events as well. We'll flag that up as well, as long as it involves a little bit of sport down the line. Whatever we can cram into those pages, if it means getting a bigger, more pages in the magazine, we'll do it. But we're always looking for sponsorship. We're always looking for support from the guys who are paying for these clubs, who are putting the big bucks into it. We're never going to get the ones that, you know, your Hall Tech and people like that are going to put in. But the name still needs to be associated with your club. So, do you have any sponsors at Cot here?
Do we have?
Yeah.
Yes.
Are they going to sponsor?
Henry Heads is one of them.
Right.
Big local
company. Yes. Been going for about 100 years, something like that.
The longest there. It's the oldest jewellers in the world.
Yeah, exactly. And we know the names as well. If we're off Rumble, we all know them. Your fruit merchants, your fish merchants and things like that. They're not the biggest.
Outside
of Hull, nobody's going to know these people. No. But we can also put them in there as well because of what they do for local teams and what they put in as well. So, good question, Simon. Thank you. Anyone else want to ask anything? Yes?
Hi, I'm Mark.
Hi, Mark.
I'm interested by the hard copy because it's quite a challenge. It must be. To get the thing printed on a weekly basis. So what's the production schedule?
We try and go to print on a Thursday, which means it's got to go to the printers Wednesday. We had a little bit of a problem this week in that we had Hull City messing up the schedule by sacking the manager, which is really bad. That's really rude. We did ring them, but obviously they didn't want to tell us. So. Yeah, absolutely. But yeah, we're trying to publish for Thursday. That's the aim. So you'll have it for the weekend. I was slightly against having it every week, but I'm sure that everybody can produce articles. We've got quite a few articles up and coming. As I said, I've got a Paul Cook interview coming up. That's going to be in two parts. And he's got a lot to say about the youth, which is what we wanted, about him being a young lad coming through the ranks. And we all know his well-publicised problems that he's had after he left Hull and took over. And now he's doing pretty well for himself at Lee. He would have been here tonight, unfortunately, but he's in Lanzarote now.